Hi everyone, this is your learning coach and so happy to meet you today. So what we are going to do over the next few days is that you guys know that we are going to be launching the Astropedia student run magazine. Okay, so this magazine is done, completely done, right from, you know, the idea stage to the complete product. Everything is done by the students of the Space Science Learning Club 30-week program, so year-long program, who are studying from grade 4 to I think about grade 9 or grade 10. Okay, so all these children have put in a lot of effort to create the magazine, to write articles for the magazine. All the magazines are 100% originally written articles. Okay, they have, you know, fun things which are there in the magazine, and this magazine is given, the digital copy of the magazine is given free of cost to all of you. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to interview a few of the students on what they have written about, what is their article about, what was the process that they followed, and any other interesting facts or interesting events that happened during the magazine making process. So without further ado, I'm going to bring Vaishnavi Dantavate on stage right now. So hi Vaishnavi.
Hello. Sir.
Hey, hi. So why don't you start with a small introduction about yourselves?
Hello everyone, I'm Vaishnavi Dandavate, grade 6 from Children's Academy School, and I'm from Mumbai, Maharashtra. I love stargazing and I have an unusual fond for space science and astronomy. So we all students have written a magazine which is called Astropedia.
Okay. Vaishnavi,
yes.
Before that, can we start from your journey with us? Like, how did you, I think you have been with us since the last 1 year, right? So
yes, sir.
You started with the summer camp last year. So last year was when we started the online model of Space Science Learning Club, and Vaishnavi was one of the first few students. So tell us,
yes,
about how you, what different programs you have taken, and then we'll come back to the magazine.
Okay, sir. So my mother noticed that I love space science and astronomy, and while on Facebook she noticed that SSLC, so she said, do you want to join? And I was like, yay, I want to join that. And I joined my first, which was the summer camp. It was a 5-day course and I loved it so much. I told my mother I need to join the next ones also, and I joined, and now I have completed 1 year, full 1 year. So I have attended many courses of Space Science Learning Club, and they are just fantastic. And yes,
yeah, so tell us about the 30-week program.
Okay,
year long.
This 30-week year long program was great, and it was a 1 year program, and I liked it. In the first classes, we started making the magazine and we did so much collaboration and we made teams to make the magazine. It was just so great. I've never had so much group communication and all that. Almost all the things I know in space science is, I have learned it from SSLC. So thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Ma. Thank you, Ma. So you are telling us about the group activity. So can you elaborate a little more on what kind of group activities? What did you do with regards to the magazine?
Regards to the magazine, we made 4 groups for the magazine, which were editorial team, content team, designing team, and marketing and outreach team. So in that, we made 4 groups and we were collaborating with each other to invent ideas and do all the things.
Okay, and you were part of which team?
I was a part of editorial team.
What did you guys do there?
Hello?
Yeah, what did you do there?
Yes, sir. We did many things, like we chose the name for the, we made polls and we chose the name for our magazine. It was just so much fun in doing that. We chose the topics to be included in our magazine.
Okay, fantastic. Yes, so the editorial team is kind of like the head and engine of, you know, the magazine.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so
sir.
These guys take up all the decisions. So decision making comes back to them, and a fantastic team of 4 people, right?
Yeah.
Four or three people.
Yeah, Ritika, me, Prathana and Shardul.
Shardul, okay. These four people, you know, brought everybody together and had to coordinate between all the teams to get, you know, the magazine up and running. I know some of you guys have already seen the magazine. So we did show you guys a preview of, you know, the magazine in the previous live videos that we did earlier. Okay, so the magazine is ready. And Vaishnavi is going to share with us right now what she has contributed as an as, you know, not just the editorial team, but every student of SSLC has to write an article in the magazine. Minimal is one, maximum is two. So Vaishnavi, I think she has done two articles in here. So she's going to share with us right now what she had written in the magazine. When you guys grab a copy of this digital magazine, what can you expect from Vaishnavi's article? So let's hear it from her.
Okay, so I've written two articles for this magazine, which are Meteor Showers and Comets. The Meteor Shower is a written article and my Comets is a video article by which you can see it from video. And in my article, I have written like what is a meteor shower and I have written what is a meteor shower, what causes a meteor shower. I've written all about meteor showers. So okay, if you don't understand.
Can you tell us what is this meteor shower? Maybe you can just give us an example of what this is.
Okay, sir. A meteor shower is a group of space rocks which fall towards the Earth in a high speed. So when they fall towards the Earth, they catch. So they look like lightning balls. And okay, the one which you call the shooting star is not a star. It's a space rock.
Okay, it's a space junk. Huh? Small meteoroids which are there in space, when they fall into Earth's atmosphere, we call it as meteor showers. Fantastic. So you have written about the difference between the meteoroids, meteor and meteorite. So can you explain us a little further about that?
Sure, sir. A meteoroid is a part of an asteroid. Now, asteroid is a rock by which when a rock's small part falls apart, it's called a meteoroid. Meteors, when the rocks come towards the Earth, they are called meteors. Meteorites, when they fall on the Earth, they are called meteorites.
Fantastic. So same object, when you find it in space, you call it as a meteoroid. When the object, you know, enters into Earth's atmosphere, you call it as a meteor. And when group of objects, okay, the same object falls into the Earth's atmosphere, you call it as a meteor shower. And yeah, most meteors, it doesn't fall onto Earth's surface because they are very, very small. So when they enter, they create a streak of light and they burn up in the atmosphere and become dust. Okay. So when they fall onto Earth's atmosphere and the Earth's surface, you call it as a meteorite. So they are like there are people I think we have discussed in the class, there are people who collect meteor rocks. Okay, so yeah, they are called meteor hunters. So they go around the places where you can find, you know, meteor impacts. Okay, and they try to find rocks which are not found on Earth, okay, which are from space. They take it to laboratories and check those rocks to find out if these rocks are kind of like from Earth or they contained, you know, other minerals from space. And a fantastic group of people. So luckily I have met one of, you know, the meteor hunters, and I did share with you my experience of it. Okay, fantastic. So hey, I wanted to ask you about what's written out over here.
Yes, sir. What's written out over here is that I've written what is a meteor shower and...
No. I want to talk about your aspirations over here. So you have written something. Can you read out?
Yes, sir. I'm Vaishni Dandavate, grade 5 Children's Academy School from Mumbai, Maharashtra. I want to build a planetarium so that people and children can learn everything about space in one place and get to become a great astronaut and an astronomer and a scientist. I also want to work in ISRO or NASA and make my family, country and everyone proud.
Fantastic. So this is your aspiration, right? Very good. And you have started working towards your aspiration?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. So what do you think you require to either go work in ISRO or NASA?
To go work in ISRO or NASA, I need a great point of knowledge.
Uh-huh.
And communication skills.
Uh-huh.
And yes, sir, that's all.
Like, come on, you did listen to Mr. Pawan, who was from ISRO. So you did listen to Dr. Abbas, who is an astronaut, okay, in training. So they gave you a lot of tips on how to become how to get a job into NASA or ISRO. So what do you think is very, very important? What you said is right. Probably the two things, one is kind of like the hunger for knowledge. So you need to be really ready to learn a lot of new things and skills. Okay. So what other skills are kind of like important when you want to go work?
Leadership skills.
Okay, very good.
Communication skills.
Okay.
I don't quite remember them, but
okay. Fantastic. So there are a few more skills. So basically you need to improve upon your 21st century skills.
Yeah.
Superb. So what is this Perseids?
Perseids is a meteor shower which comes in August.
Okay.
It's a great meteor shower.
Okay.
So I've also written what causes a meteor shower. Shall I explain that?
Yes, please.
Okay, sir. What causes a meteor shower is that a meteor shower is caused by a comet. When a comet goes past the Earth, it leaves some debris in the orbit, in our orbit. And when the Earth comes past these debris, they fall down to the Earth. The debris are pulled by the gravity of the Earth. And okay. That is how a meteor shower is formed.
Fantastic. So, any guess how many meteor showers happen during a year?
A year?
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure, but I know in each day. It's 250 okay. million meteors.
Okay, so every day thousands and thousands of meteors enter into Earth's atmosphere. But there are about 12 to 15 large meteor showers, which are kind of like, you know, a treat for stargazers to watch. Okay, so those are kind of like very good. So you are talking about, you know, the meteor showers. So you said you want to share with us a couple of websites or other links, you know,
yes,
interesting
sir.
Facts about meteor showers. Huh? So yes,
I have a website which I think will really help you to watch the meteor showers at perfect timing and where will they begin. So that website is timanddate.com.
Okay, can you share the website? Can you open up the link and show us how to see that?
Just a second.
Sure. Take your time.
So shall I share screen now?
Yes, please.
Can you see?
Yes.
Yes, sir. So here, when you come in the timeanddate.com, you can go in the sun and moon.
Uh-huh.
And here you can see eclipses, live streams, day and night map. And here you can see meteor showers. Just
okay.
Click on the showers. And see, you can see all the meteor shower dates and the times.
Uh-huh.
Your location, like I live in Mumbai, so I've written here Mumbai. We can change your location and watch all the meteor showers.
Okay.
Yeah,
and the next meteor is going to be the ETA Aquarius, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can you click on the ETA Aquarius?
Yes, yeah, sir.
Okay.
You can select your night, your date. Mm-hmm. You can see. Here you can see the sun and see it's coming from here.
Okay.
It's starting from this point.
So this point is called as the radiant.
Yeah.
Okay, so the radiant is near to the star ETA Aquarius, so that's why it's called as ETA Aquarius meteor shower. Okay, yes. And then come down. So nice. So the website gives you enough information about what the ETA Aquarix meteor shower is, and during the peak, which is happening on 5th night and 6th morning. Okay, so it's, you're going to see about 50 meteors per hour. So that's a very nice meteor shower. So the Liritz was a little dull. So Liritz, we were able to see somewhere about 20 to 25 meteors per hour. But then because of too much cloud, we were only able to see 2 or 3 meteors. But really hoping that Aquarix is going to be much brighter and much bigger, and it's going to create a fantastic experience for stargazers and astronomy lovers to go out and see the meteor showers. Okay, Vaishnavi, why don't you tell us about the comets article that you have written, the second article. So what Vaishnavi has done is that she has written a video article. So you're going to have a link to the video in the magazine. So just click on it and it will take you to YouTube, where she's going to share an amazing video about comets. But why don't you explain that?
Yes, sir. So what I exactly have in my comet video is that what are comets, composition, and composition means the parts of a comet. So I will explain. I have explained all the parts clearly, and I've also given the fact that the tail points always away from the sun of the comet. I've given that fact, and I have also explained 3 comets, which are Comet Neowise, which just happened last year. Comet Shoemaker-Levy 9. That comet had crashed into Jupiter. I have done that. And the most famous comet I have done, which is Halley's Comet.
Okay.
And I have also explained 2 missions which landed and crashed into the comet, which was Deep Impact Temple 1. And the second was the Rosetta mission.
Rosetta, fantastic.
Crash and
landed on missions, right? Like when we are talking about a comet is not a stationary object. It's not a large object. It's not a stationary object. So imagine a moderate sized rock, okay, flying through space, and here we are, human beings, sending a satellite to sending a rover to actually land on an object which is kind of like, you know, traveling at great speeds, okay, yes. Trying to measure it and land it out over there. So fantastic what we are doing to learn more about comets. And one of the reasons why we learn more about comets is that comets are objects which have not changed much ever since the formation of our solar system. So our Earth, all the planets in the inside of, you know, the solar system has changed considerably. But comets, since they are kind of like very, very far away, they have not changed much. So when we study about the comets, we understand how our solar system was kind of like, you know, formed. So that's the reason why studying about comets is very, very interesting. Okay. And comets also has got this weird, weird myth. I don't know. Yesterday I was listening to a podcast about a story, okay, about a king who lived a few thousand years back. Okay. So in that story, they say they were able to spot a comet, and whenever comets are seen in the sky, something disastrous happens in the world. Okay, some great people, you know, die and stuff like that. So I was hearing that and I was like, oh my God, last year we saw 2 comets. So we saw Neowise and we also saw Comet Swan, I believe.
Yeah.
Okay. So is that the reason why entire year was kind of like, you know, washed out and nothing was happening? So we were all inside. Is this kind of true? And yesterday I was thinking I should, you know, start doing a research on comet sightings and see if this saying that comets bring bad news to human beings is really true.
It's like, if you want to know what's a comet, if you see a broom in the sky, the tail of a comet is just like a broom. So if you see a broom in the sky, say it's a comet. It's white in color and it's made of ice and dust and all that.
Actually, Vaishnavi, the comets have got 2 different colors. So the tail of a comet, technically you can see 2 different tails. So
yeah,
one is the
dust tail, tail and the iron tail.
Yeah, the one is the metal ion tail. Okay, so that will be in different colors. So it will not be in just white. Based on the metal, it will be blue, it will be red, it will be black, and different colors. And then, as you said, there's the powdery icy layer on the comet, so which will give out a white tail. So fantastic! You have shown all these things as pictures and in your article, yeah. Right? Fantastic. So yeah. Very nice. Okay. Any last message for people who are going to read your article?
People who are going to read my article, please read this. Please read my this magazine. It's really great and it doesn't cost any rupees. It's all fully free. It's a digital magazine, so please read it. You will there are many fun activities in it, and you will just enjoy doing those activities. With doing activities, you will learn new things and become a space scientist. Thank you.
Fantastic, ma'am. Thank you so much. Just as thank you so much, Joe. Just as Vaishnavi said, what we are going to do is that just underneath this video, you will find the article link. You will find the link to get the magazine. The magazine is going to be launched on the 9th of May. Okay, so on Sunday, 9th May, between 4 p.m. and 5 p.m., we are going to launch the magazine, and it's going to be a gala event. So we are going to have a few celebrity astronomers who are going to come in and wish the kids. And we are going to have all the authors of the magazine there. They're going to share their experience. They're going to share, conduct fun activities for all of you. So looking forward for you to join this program. What I would really want from you is to sign up in the link below. So once you sign up, you will be able to get the magazine as soon as it is launched. Okay. So probably on 9th, we are launching it. So 10th, you will have, the copy of the magazine emailed to you. So without further ado, please do register. And looking forward to see you with another student interview. This is your learning coach, Vinod, signing off. See you. Bye-bye.